welcome to the world's first invisible hula hoop competition. Not really. It's Aylestone Athletic versus Stoneygate, otherwise known as Uppingham, in Uppingham, in what is sure to be a top-of-the-table clash. In fact, there's the table, and we're at the top, by virtue of having one more game played than anyone else. There's the team. Feel free to pause now if you're into that sort of thing. A few last-minute changes. And Baywatch is in on the bench to make sure we've got the prerequisite number of hairless teenage boys. Nice little bit of warming up here. Something we like to call Smash the Bag Man. And that's good to see. Those boys are warmed and ready. So without further ado, let's get this game underway in what's sometimes referred to as the kickoffs. And it's up in the air, it's up, and that's gone forwards, and the ball's on the floor, and it's messy. And that's a disappointing start to the game. But if you're a purist, that's probably the best start you could have hoped for, because it's straight into the scrummaging. That's a good, steady platform there. Oh, and the Ath are rampaging in that scrum there. And the boys put it along the line, and it's Darkings on the wing. But the ref says there was some bad rugby there. Let's have another scrum. So another scrum it is. This time it's Stoneygate put in. Oh, and again, the Ath are dominant in the pack there. We have some big boys this week. But the boys of Gate have done well to get it out, and their big number 8 is trucking it up down the blind side. This pick and go technique is well known from Stoneygate. That's an interesting technique there of carrying the ball in on your arse cheek. But his mate was wise to it and took it off him before he could do any damage. G says, no way, this door is closed, you sit down. But the Gates still have the ball and they recycle it along their back line. That's a big hit there from new boy Alistair. And another pick and go. And Ed Webb, yep, confirmed, he's asleep. Just had to pause it there to confirm. He has put his head on the wrong side of that tackle and he's having 40 winks and the game pulls up, but it's okay because he's fine. I just had to pause out there for that majestic leap. But the 15 runs it back in with a strong, takes a strong hit from Sam Morandi with his trademark blue legs. Oh, and that's a big charge down. Big Kyle on the charge down. He hoofs that one. He says, get wrecked. I'm chasing this. But he's put a little bit too much mustard on that ball. And it's rolled out. Bit of a mess here. The red shirts and the red shirts combining into a bit of a red nightmare for the casual spectator. And that ball's loose. But Owens pounce on it and step. Whoa! Did you see that? He has cut through space and time to defy gravity there with that step, and G slots the extras. We like that. There you go, flags are up. Happy times. Another restart, this time gathered by Captain Mert Goonwell, who's instantly taken to ground, but that's a strong clear out there from his supporters. G pops the ball onto Will. Will takes it in, and there's Sam Randy with his blue legs again, but unfortunately the rucking hasn't gone to plan. We've got the advantage, and Corley comes in the side to say, we've got the advantage, I'm taking this ball. Much to the consternation of the supporters. Another ruck here, the ball's come out to Will. Will's trucked it in, taking three men in. Some great rucking there again from Sam Randy. Corley with the quick hands to G, who's tapped it on to Kyle. Kyle over the top, and somewhere behind that man, the ball goes into touch. Stoneygate line out, captured by their leaping salmon of a six at the back there. And they're using it, sprinting it down the line, cutting back against play, and that's a rip. That's a Sam Morandi patented rip. Jack's all over it, feeds it up to Kyle again with the quick hands, dummies the man, takes the tackle, and he's given that to the wrong person. And you can see on the floor here him saying, they're all wearing red, what am I supposed to do? Another scrum. quick ball out the back of the scrum to Corley, feeds it on to Owen. Owen steps two men, steps a third man, almost has his head taken off, but pops it up to Will, and Will's over the line for a try. Lovely, lovely stuff. And G slots it, just to be sure. Two more points. Slow motion running shots. There's a scrum here, again dominance from the Ath, but the Gate have done well to get the ball out, and they're playing down their blind side with some quick hands, and their sniping little nine is in over the line. Try to Gate. Another scrum. I didn't bother counting this week. I can't count that high. Fed nicely, hooked nicely, and it's out to Corley. Corley hoofs one. Oh, but the winger has done well. That has stuck to his chest. But he's run head-on into a doubled Sam sandwich. But the ball comes back on the Gate side. Some good hands there. Not so good hands there. But they've reclaimed it. Slight hint of a high tackle there from Darkins, but we'll give him the benefit of the doubt because we're biased. Oh, half a break, but he's caught down by a great covering tackle by Jack Whitmore. And something resembling a maul comes to ground there. And again, quick hands down the blind side. Finds a half break. Not quite clear what's going on in this sea of redness. Oh, that's a huge dusted counter ruck. And something bad happened, and there was a penalty. Another dominant at scrum, but again, Gate have done well to get the ball out. And there's all sorts of fighting going on there. But the ref says, that's a rugby. I like that rugby. Another restart, as is the way, and that's not been dealt with well. This guy does very well to duck what would have been an absolute headshot of a tackle from Kyle. Oh, but it's been knocked on in midfield. That's not going to make the highlights real. Another scrum, nice little bit of 8-9 interplay there, and Jack gets wrecked for his whatever. The ball has come back on the Ath side though, and the boys pick and go whilst Jack recovers his senses. And now he's there, feeds it to G, and oh, he hasn't held on to that, and that's a shame. Another dominant Ath scrum, but again Gate have done very well to get the ball out of there. And a nice clearance kick straight into Harry Cooper's hands. He dummies a man, steps two, offloads to Owen, and somewhere behind the flag, and behind the... he scores a rugby in the corner. And yep, there it is. Confirmation from the referee.
He is the winner!
And something bad happened, and Gate got a penalty in front of the posts. Nice work off the back of the scrum here, some good hands. Oh, and new boy Alistair has beaten two men. But the covering eight is there and yanks him to the ground before he can make the offload. And turnover and Gate boot it out. Another scrum. Story of the game. Scrum. Corley switches up the play. He comes back on the blind side. But there's men there. You drag him down. It sets the platform. It's G at the front of a pod. Offloads to new boy Joe. Joe steps one man, oh, has his head taken off by another man, and he's down. We recycle though, going again. Big Nick, oh, he won't enjoy seeing that again. He has been taken out like the trash. But he's kept the ball back. We've recycled it, and has come along the line. Nice hands, Corley to Owen. Owen is step two, feeds Kyle. Kyle with the last pass, and Harry Cooper is in. G steps up to slot the extra two, makes it look like he's going to miss, but bends it back in the wind. That is professional stuff. Nice switch there, has fooled the defence, and the gate are through on a half break. Dragged down by a nice covering tackle from new boy Alistair. They've recycled onto the open side where they've got numbers, and it's good hands along the back line. And it looks like they're almost in for sure in the corner, but a great covering tackle from Owen is enough to stop them. Another scrum restart, and we've got some good hands here along the back line. And there's Harry with a break. Owen juggling, but he can't step the last man. Tries to offload, and it ends up in the hands of a Gate player. Line out here on our 22. Gate take. Nicely tackled to ground there by new boy Sam. But they keep on the maul, keep the ball alive. There's a pick and go from the base. But Will says, not today. I'm closing this door. But unfortunately, when one door closes, another one opens, and the Gate slip through for a try. That's a strong pick off the back of the scrum, but Will is man enough to bring him to ground. And it's a bit scrappy off the floor. They're looking menacing here. There's a half break through that tackle. The man's wrapped up short the line. Some strong try line defence here. And the last man is ushered into touch. Crisis averted, but a penalty was scored thereafter. Restarting from the penalty here, putting a kick right down Owen's throat. He steps two men with ease, has a little laugh about it. Jack says, what is this? This does not look like a ruck. And the referee agrees and says, no, that's a penalty. Another scrum, again with the backs now. Dummy switch in midfield. Mark shirks off two tacklers, gives a nice high ball to Owen just where he wants them, and Owen does a little chip through, but a Gate player is the first one to get there and touch it down for an own try. From the ensuing own try scrum, nothing good happened. Sometime thereafter was a line out. Slight hint of a forward pass there, but good work from the Gate backs here. And this guy, 2-on-1, simple. Oh, that is criminal. He has butchered a simple 2-on-1. He will be unpopular this evening at the dinner table. Ath backs threatening here with a half break, but the ball's been turned over. And Harry Cooper has absolutely buried the opposition 9. He is 6 feet under, but they're keeping the ball alive down the blind there. Gate recycling the ball back onto their side and spinning it out through their backs. And we have a half chance here. Owen's done what we like to call the kick balls and kick the ball, but the referee says no, all of that was crap. Yet another scrum, and this one a strong hook and a half drive for the Ath, and it's clean ball. G feeds new Alistair inside to Owen, but Owen can't quite pick it up off his laces. Another penalty here for Gate, making up the points, and now even. It's now 0-0, as they say. Nice maul off the line out there. New boy Sam doing his best Johnny May scrummaging impression. But Gate have ripped it, they've turned it over, and now they're on the attack. End-to-end stuff. Quick recycling, quick play the ball is getting them good yards here as our back line struggle to get back into their defensive position. But they've kicked it away straight to Owen again. Owen's kicked it away straight to them. A little bit of kick tennis, but he's held onto the man and dragged him down. And then now they've offloaded to Harry Cooper, but now Harry Cooper's offloaded to one of them. And now they make a break. This is frenetic stuff. Non-stop rugby's Oh, Dustin gets a little bit of a face push there for his troubles. And they've picked and gone down the side of the ruck. This is dangerous at 26 all. It's with their big eight. And he is absolutely trucked over Corley. Corley will not like to see that. And he scored under the posts. Devastating.
If you filmed that, can you send that to us?
It'll be on YouTube.
Oh, okay. That's like the best thing we've ever done.
And as you heard there, the fans on the sideline pretty happy with that try. We are now in extra time. The clock is dead. There is no pulse. Time or death a few minutes ago. But we're running on fumes. This is probably the most sustained period of pressure we had in the entire game as the boys desperately bang on the door. 7 points down, a converted try would draw the game, which would be some recompense for the amount of effort exerted in this fixture. It would save a few blushes, certainly. That's a nice lobbed pass there to G. Steps two men, hands off another, takes the ball to ground to recycle it. This is tense, frenetic stuff. My heart is in my throat, and my pants are rather brown. That's a nice ruck there with Big Nick crashing it up. Corley steps in at nine again. Pops it out to New Sam. New Sam goes around one man. Pirouettes. Looks like he's broken his ankle and or his knee. He hasn't. He takes it to ground. He's safe. We're all happy. Pops it up to Mark Goomwell, who takes in the crash. Plays the ball back. Gets his face stood on. Ball fed out to G on the open side, just to keep things fresh and interesting. Someone there getting a bit of a tap on the ribs to say, stop being a naughty boy, get your hands out of the way. That's new boy Sam again, crashing it up. Some solid rucking going on here. Some great phases. I'm not even counting, but it's lots of phases. And oh my god, something has happened in the corner. And it looks like it's a try. Andy Darkins gets up and says, that's all me. But as it were, that was the game. And it was a big ask from the touchline. Lots of stern words being said here. McGonnell got a bit angry, and that got me a little bit sad. A disappointing loss to a game that at one point was very much ours. But as is ever the way, we retired to the old horse for drinks galore, Jaeger bombs, and much, much more. Two losses, an unfortunate weekend for the Ath, but great fun had thereafter. And as you fire up your air base and play on into the night, we drink for Jimmy. Come.